back from Sazon Studios with my good friend Mario, DJ Mario in the mix. Say what's up.
Hey everybody, it's been a long time. Happy to be here with you on a Friday night. I hope everybody having a good Friday. We're getting ready for the weekend. So, George, I know you're going to prepare some drinks for us tonight.
We're back. It's been a while, guys. It's been like over 6 months since our last Mixology night. But tonight's theme, it's all 90s theme. We're going to make 90s cocktails, 90s DJ mixes, and Mario got some nice throwbacks from back in the day. So get ready for some of that good stuff. As people come in, of course, this is live. I'm also on TikTok over here, but if you're watching on TikTok, jump on the Sazon channel. We're live here on YouTube. We're also celebrating 1,000. We have over 1,000 subscribers, so that's our first milestone with the channel. So I'm excited, and I'm happy to be celebrating here with you guys tonight. So in a little bit, we're going to make some cocktails. What's good, Mario? What you been up to?
Busy with work, busy with parties. We're back, you know. Thankfully, everybody wants to party now and day.
COVID's over now. It's...
Call me, need me. You know, I make sure we set the party mood right. Yeah. But yes, I mean, it's good things going on right now. I mean, I think we're heading the right way now.
Yeah, it's good. I know. Yeah, I'm excited. And yeah, but we've been doing, on my end, I've been doing some live cooking classes. I'm at the Sistrunk Market. There you go. Thank you. And I'll get the fancy shot here.
Put the pinky out.
Pinky up. This is our lemon drop.
Lemon drop.
So let's drop that. Cheers, guys. Cheers everybody at home. Happy Friday.
Happy Friday. Cool. Oh. Yes.
Like lemonade.
Yes.
That's a sneaky one. That's a sneaky one.
That's the one that, yeah.
I just wanted to get you loose, Mario, because you're going to hit us with your first set.
Yes, I am.
Let's do this.
When you mention lemon drop, that just reminds me of going back to the 90s.
When you used to drop it?
When I used to drop it.
You used to do little drop moves? Mario's quite a dancer. If you don't know, Mario can dance.
No, but it just reminds me of dance hall, you know? Yeah. Like that good old dance hall.
I'm in love with the man and those kind of...
Well, I hope you're in love with the woman, but yeah. But yes.
You can love whoever you like.
We're gonna go into dance hall, 90 dance hall. So let's take it back in the days.
Oh my God, yeah, back to the boom boom room. Let's go to the boomer. Oh, this always gets a party going back in the 90s.
Oh yeah.
Right here is where all the girls are like, oh, it's not yet. Here, let me top up your shot too.
Watch this.
Oh. Oh snap. If this is what's getting us started, I'm liking this. I'm liking this, Mario. All right. I'm going to throw you guys a little video about Sazon, and then we're going to get started with some cocktails.
We'll be right back.
our sponsors, Sazon. All right, so we're gonna get started, guys, with our main cocktail, our first cocktail of the night. This side of the 90s comes a little bit more on the later side of the 90s, a little in the girl power and the girly vibes of the 90s. This is a Sex and the City inspired cocktail. This is a cocktail that was a favorite of a popular character in Sex and the City. If you know who this character is, leave it in the comments. I think ask your girl, she knows. Or Mr. Stereo Girl, I'm sure he knows. All right, so we're gonna make a sour Appletini. I'm sure you've seen it too. That was one of the first martinis that I used to drink back in the day. Cosmos were popular back in the days. I think the martini blew up in the 90s. And the craft cocktail scene, the espresso martini was in back then. If you think it was hot now, back then is when it was really hot. You know, everybody was drinking martinis. How I got to love olives, you know, Mario, was having a martini.
Oh, really?
I hated, like, you know, when they ask a chef, you like everything, right? You're a chef. Or what ingredients you don't like? I'm like, you know, one of the ingredients I hated growing up was olives.
Yeah, I can't get into olives.
No, you don't like them either?
No.
And the only way I got to enjoy olives was drinking a martini, a dirty martini. So I liked the dirty brine, and then I started eating olives, and that's a beautiful story of how I became a martini lover, or an olive lover, really, and a martini lover. But enough of my tangent with the sour Appletini. This cocktail originates from, it's in the 90s, from in California and Los Angeles. So it travels all the way back from there.
So wait, so it started in Los Angeles, but it got popular and...
Yeah, bartender in Los Angeles started. I can't remember his name. I had it in my notes, but Google it.
That's crazy how during that time, right? It started in Los Angeles, but it got popular in the New York atmosphere because of the show.
Yeah, because in New York and because of the show, it exploded with the show. There was a lot of foodie pop culture things in the show that really blew up. Cupcakes was one of those things. I don't know what else, but I didn't really watch the show. I watched a lot of episodes, but... So, did you watch Sex and the City?
I was a fan.
So, which one of the girls would you be?
If I was one of the girls?
I
can't... you know what? Listen, I was always Samantha. Samantha was... Samantha was... She's the G.
Who's the Samantha in the room? Okay, yeah.
Samantha, yeah.
I like Samantha, of course. Samantha and Carrie. They all have their nice quirks.
I don't know. Carrie was just, I don't know. Samantha was
yeah, Samantha, she was about it. Samantha's a G.
Yeah,
she... I like Samantha.
Yeah.
But, all right. But, anywho, look at us, a bunch of guys talking about Sex and the City.
I know, right?
If you're a fan of that, put that in the comments or whatever.
Don't put this on the...
Yeah. Let's talk about Friends, yeah. All right, so Sour Appletini. I loved this cocktail back in the day. I'm like, I don't even know why I stopped liking it. I think it's because the green is kind of too girly, but... Adam, you know, you're not too girly to have a cocktail. So, you ready for this? Let's get the party cracking. We're gonna get some martini glasses. Always when making a cocktail, a craft cocktail, you wanna be prepared with all your glassware and all your tools. So have that, these nice sexy martini glasses ready to go. And this is another simple recipe. We're gonna get your shaker, get some ice. How much ice? You know, I always say when I'm making a cocktail, about a cup to a cup and a half of ice.
Okay. A full cup or of what you're using in the mixer right now?
Like a cup measure, like an actual cup measure. Gotcha, but this actually holds about probably 3 or 4 cups in here.
Oh, okay.
Like 3 cups in here. So I would fill it up like, let's say half of the shaker, even easier measurement. Half, a little bit over the half.
Okay, cool.
This is gonna help it keep it nice and cold. And the water's also, it becomes an ingredient. So this, the ice becomes, as you shake it, you're gonna get these little tiny shards of ice, which makes it kind of frothy, and almost has a little bit of that crispy, frosty bite. So a nice cold shaken martini should have that kind of like creamy, icy, little tiny icy pieces in there.
Got it.
And then the water is going to dilute some of the vodka, because vodka can be strong. And when you drink a martini, you ever had a 3 martini lunch? You're not going back to work.
Oh.
You're probably a 2 martini.
Maybe.
2 martini, yeah. 2 martinis, yeah, you're...
Because if I take 3, I'll turn into Samantha.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, for sure. All right, so Kettle one. We're going to do 2 ounces of vodka. I'm making double the recipe because I'm hooking up my friend over here. So you can eyeball it at home. If you have your little jigger, your little measuring cup, measure. You know, I always say when you're following a recipe or making a cocktail for the first time, follow the recipe. That way you have an idea what it tastes like. If you want to go hard in the paint and put an extra shot of boost, help yourself.
Yeah, it's always good because at least you know where you're at, and if you want to add a little bit based on your taste.
Yeah, yeah. We're going for flavor. If you want to get sloshed, just keep having shots.
And lemon drop.
And drop. All right, so 2 ounces of vodka, 1 ounce of apple puckers, sour apple. This almost smells like that Jolly Rancher.
Oh, yeah, right? It does.
Straight up Jolly Rancher. You can take a shot of that, but don't do that. So an ounce of this, I'm going to double this. This is what's going to give it that beautiful little sexy green color. And then for the original recipe called for sour mix. So the sour mix, it's almost like the margarita mix, a little lemon lime kind of mixture. You can make your own. I like to put fresh lemon juice, and I like to add a touch of lime juice. I love lime juice in my cocktails. So we're gonna put a little fresh lime. I'll squeeze that right on there. And let me make some room over here, boom.
That's that Hispanic part.
Yeah. I like lime. I think lime is such a different tartness.
Yeah, it is.
So different. I love the combination of both lemon and lime together. There's like sweet and tart, and it's just like a nice harmony of citrus together.
Yes, I agree.
So let's shake that up. I was in San Francisco a couple weeks back, or a month ago.
Right.
And I went to I was at the hotel to get a drink, and they had this machine where it has these cups, and you put your cup in there, and the bartender spins the wheel, and it's like an automatic cocktail mixer.
Oh, nice.
It's really badass. Yeah. I'll show you my phone. I'll post some of my Instagram, a couple pictures of that, a video of that.
I mean, just looking at it, shaking it manually, you're about to blow your
head. Oh, she's like spinning the wheel, and the thing's like,
that's awesome.
It's crazy. Heavy duty martini making. All right, so we're gonna pour our.
Oh, yeah, it looks very frosty.
Yeah, you want it nice and cold. I miss the sidecar. Back in the day, they'll give you a little sidecar on the rocks. But you can put your ex's cocktail in there. Here, they don't do that anymore. Very few places do that. Things like a nice old school touch. And then we're gonna garnish this. It's always nice to have a little garnish. Just a little.
Oh, the apple slice.
Yeah, a little sour apple, a green apple. So I'm gonna cut a couple thin slices. Give a little slit because we're gonna hang it in there. And I also have this little sour sugar for like the sour candies.
Got it.
This is an extra little treat. This is just gonna add a little puckery sourness to it. Almost like your gummies have that little sugar.
Yeah.
So you're just gonna put them on both sides. Shake off the excess. Yeah, hey, look at that.
Nice.
Someone broke. There you go. A little sexy martini is going on. Look at this. Ladies' night. There's a 2-for-1 ladies' night over here at Sazon. Here you go.
Nice. Ladies, just know if you want to get your drink on,
sour Appletini is the way to go. This is a throwback 90s, early 2000s.
Cheers.
Cocktail. Cheers, homie.
Look at
that
me.
That was filling. Oh, look at us.
Yeah, look at us.
Fancy.
Let me put the pinky out.
Cheers. Yo, and cheers to the Miami Heat. Miami Heat on fuego and fire, man.
Yeah, for all those South Florida fans, you know, sports right now is really popping. We got the Heat, the Panthers, but just the Heat taking out the number one
seed. Jimmy Buckets, man. Yeah. It's crazy. The Knicks were coming for you. This is all Heat fans here, Heat Nation here, by the way. So it's a.
Yes. Yes.
Full takeover.
But before we get there, you know, let's have a drink, you know?
Yeah.
let's enjoy the martini. You know, this martini is pretty good.
It's nice, right? So what do you get, like, flavor-wise?
I do taste the apple. So it's very, like, It has that sour, but very smooth sour.
Yeah, it tastes just like a candy watermelon.
Right.
Like a Jolly Rancher.
It's a creeper. I'll say that much.
It's another creeper.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. One more and I'm a creeper.
I'm telling you, Samantha.
All right, well, get the party started, Samantha. We're gonna hit you up with mix number two.
You know what I love about the 90s was the dance part of the 90s. That was the era.
90s so. Club was the snap. I wasn't in the club in the 90s. I was more in the early 2000s, but the music, I wish I was in the club in the 90s.
Yeah, me too.
90s. I was still in high school, finishing.
So for you that may not know, I'm gonna take you back to that time frame. So.
What you got?
Show us some love here in the chat. Let me know what you want to hear. Let's go.
Oh, yeah.
Get right, let's go. Get your martini on. Let's go. Show me love. For those that don't know love, we're taking a night Roxbury. Let's go. SNL. Let's go. Without Madonna.
Nope. Like a virgin. I feel like a virgin with this Apple Martini. It's been a while since I had this. It's good.
Let's Vogue. taking you back in the days. Some of you thought this was Kanye. No, no, no. This is 90s. Let's go. Watch it, watch it.
It's me, Mario.
Let's go.
Anybody comment or?
Drinks, let us know, you know, but if you want to groove, I get it. I'm putting you in that mood. Let's go. It's Friday. Everybody know. La dee la da. Hey! Watch this, watch this, watch this. You want to work out, you can work out. I got George working out here. Let's go. Everybody.
Alizé, it's hard to find it around here. I called my buddy at the liquor store, Harmid. He owns a liquor store.
Yeah,
he's like, you gotta go to the hood. I'm like, oh man. So try to find Alizé. So the next cocktail is called Thug Passion, made popular by Tupac. And there's a song called Thug Passion.
Yeah.
And he starts off by saying he says the recipe. So there's a couple ways to make it, but some people say there's Hennessy, some people say there's not. Back in the day, I remember some people would just do Alizé and Hennessy. Have you ever had Alizé on its own before?
Oh, a long time ago.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is so Alizé. It's a spirit made with vodka and different kind of fruits. Like this one's passion fruit. I think they put cranberry. They have mango and peach. You know, it's like a nice sweet.
Yeah.
Really more of a mixer. So this next cocktail that I'm gonna make in a little bit, it's called Thug Passion, and it's a combination of the name is almost like a play on a poet. You know, Tupac is very poetic in a lot of his rhymes. So Thug Passion is a combination of the harshness of the streets, which is the Hennessy, and the Alizé. You know, if you're using the red one, it's like more like blood. Yeah. So if you ever see that red Alizé cocktail, that's made with the red one. I couldn't find it. I got the passion fruit one. So that's the thug, the hard, the streets.
What flavor is the red one?
I think it's like a berry.
Okay.
And then what softens it up is the glam champagne. So this is a combination of something harsh and something glitzy. And that's what the thug passion is. I'm gonna get started and make that. Pop a little bottles over here. We got some Hennessy. I got a little fifth over here.
Does it matter, like, what does any champagne?
Yeah, any sparkling, yeah. Okay. You can go fancy. I mean, if you're a baller, a hip-hop baller in the 90s, what were you drinking back then? What was the champagne back in the day? Dom P? Cristal.
Now it's Ace of Spades.
Ace of Spades. I don't know. What's the popular champagne? this what I'm using is Hateau Couture, French Bubbles Blanc. So any champagne, if it comes from the city of Champagne in France, by law it can only be called champagne. If it's not produced within Champagne, that region, it's got to be called sparkling wine, or you call it whatever the heck you want, not mine. Yeah.
Ah,
it's like the key, right? It's the French, you know, it's really good. So they own that territory. Like, you can't name any product, any sparkling wine, champagne, only if it's produced from that region of France.
Got it.
So, like in Italy, for example, they don't drink this, they drink Prosecco.
Oh.
So Prosecco is there, or the Asti Spumanti is another different kind of sparkly. In Spain, they have Cava. It's another sparkling grape. In the States, they call it just sparkling wine.
Got it.
So, and there's different kind of sparkling little wine. I love anything with bubbles. So.
So just know if you travel, Chef Sazon is telling you how the right way to say it.
Yes, of course. I'm your culinary shaman. I'm here to guide you in all your culinary ways.
Nice.
So what you're going to need is champagne, pop your champagne. So this is almost, it can be a little spritzer, but I think the addition of Hennessy makes it kicks it up. So let's make this cocktail. Again, mix it up with a different shaker, just because. Let's ice that up. Ice in the shaker. We're gonna put some Hennessy. We're gonna put 1 ounce of Hennessy. So, nice shot of Hennessy, cognac.
Can never go wrong with the Hennessy.
Hennessy, yeah. This is, if it's a hip hop party, Hennessy's in the house. You know that. I don't mind. I cannot drink too much Hennessy. This will get me bend the knee.
Yeah.
A little chat in there. So we're going to put our Hennessy in the shaker. We're going to put Alizé, 2 ounces of Alizé. And this, you know, the Alizé is so, it's almost like a sweet tang.
Yeah.
It's like, it's so flavorful that it kind of like takes over whatever you're serving it with. Put it over here. And we're gonna shake that up. I'm gonna get our glasses as well. That's what I was looking for.
Cool.
Champagne glasses. You can serve it in champagne glasses. When I was in the club, the thugs will have it in a regular club. Glass, yeah.
Yeah, you won't
But it doesn't matter. If you wanna get your pinky up and celebrate life, who is gonna tell you not to celebrate?
Yeah.
If you wanna keep it low key, you can do a glass, do whatever you like. I'm gonna go with a champagne glass, because it toasts into the good life. You're shaking Hennessy and Alizé, goes from the bottom. So think of it almost like a mimosa. But I would say half of the mixture is your hard liquor. And then you just top it off with your champagne. That's gonna give you a nice shot of Hennessy. It's still gonna give you that nice bubbly, so it's still a nice mixed cocktail. Look at that.
I'm dripping. Champagne comes afterwards.
Yeah, let's pop it up. Look at that. Looks like a picture over here. Got excited here.
It's the burst.
Yeah, there you go. The thug in me got excited. Here you go. The thug in me honors the thug in you.
Thank you, thank you.
Here, let me clean that up. All right, so here we have our thug passion.
Oh, cheers, very homie. Smooth. Sorry to start it, but it's smooth. Yeah. It's very good.
You taste the Hennessy in there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking about. Like, oh, I'm like, this is smooth, and I'm drinking like, and then you just remind me, you got Hennessy. I'm like,
there's Hennessy in there. Yeah.
The Alizé
is a masquerade.
Let me sip on it.
Yeah, yeah. It kind of deviates you from thinking that there's Hennessy in here, but there is. So this is a Thug Passion.
Nice. Did anyone was able to go ahead and make that Thug Passion in the chat?
They're not making Thug Passion.
This is that good drink, though.
Yeah, so you know that Tupac song, Thug Passion. That's
yeah, actually, I mean, he's such a creative artist. He took that Computer Love, you know, sample.
Yeah.
That's actually the sample in Thug Passion, Computer Love from The Whispers. Oh, no, not The Whispers.
Oh, really?
But, yeah.
Put it on. All right, new drink. One part Alizé, one part Crystal. And and this is a celebration. This is another toast. It's our 1,000 subscribers.
Nice, congrats.
We did that in March, but I figured, you know, we wanted to get the Mixology back.
Yeah.
It's been a while, we haven't had it, and I missed it, and I miss you guys, and now that we have our subscribers, we're gonna do these more often, and I'm gonna start throwing some more classes live. And if you didn't check on the channel, I posted a brand new video today. I made a choripan. Have you ever had choripan?
Yes, actually, I have.
Yeah, of course. In Miami, yeah. Choripan is always choripan.
Yeah. But I like your recipe, though.
Yeah? You haven't tried the recipe?
Well, I mean, you just put it today.
Yeah, yeah.
But it looks very, very interesting.
But you have a chimichurri before in the past.
Your chimichurri is the best.
Yeah, you had it in the past.
Have you ever never tried Chef Sazon chimichurri? You don't know what chimichurri
is. Yeah, that sounds like the bomb. fun fact. I started my first business when I was 20 years old. I opened my first company. It was called Chef George Chimichurri. And I used to make chimichurri in jars and sell it at gas stations.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And that's how I started. That was my first wetting my toes into the entrepreneurial side of things.
Wow.
It's making chimichurri sauce, yeah.
I go to a restaurant, and when they give me chimichurri, it's like, you took it to the next level, so it's like...
It's easy. You just got to be fresh.
But got to be fresh?
Yeah, that's the key.
Yeah, I remember I used to tell you, George, you have any extra chimichurri? And you were like, yeah, I got you. In a big jar. I ate it with everything.
Yeah. All right, take us home, Mario. Mario's going to take us back to the 90s, some little hip-hop. Back to the streets.
Back to the streets?